Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. In our previous tutorial, we had a detailed discussion on the difference operation in objects, in paths, and in between a path and an object. Now, in this tutorial, we are going to know about the union operation being conducted into Inkscape vector graphics tutorial. So, stay tuned. Now, in the first case, we will be observing the union between two objects. Now, in the first case, this is the case one, this is the union when the rectangle is at the bottom and the circle is on the top. And what is the basic difference between an union operation and grouping of two different elements? So, if we now head back to our Inkscape document, and first of all, we will be creating a rectangle at the bottom with some different properties, like this is a different color property here. As we can see, we have a separate fill color and we have another set of stroke color right over here. Now, this is the first case where we are having a rectangle as an object, and then we will be drawing another circle. And additionally, what we are about to do, we are going to change the color fill and stroke properties of this circle object here. So if we now head back to this color palette, and if we click on any of these elements, for say we are choosing this red color, and the stroke color will be a red color too. So let's increase this stroke color a little bit for up to this one, it will be all right. Now we have two different objects here. The bottom leveled element is a rectangle, and the top level element here is a circle. Now if we select both, and if we head back to this path, and if we press on this union, we can see that the top level circle element, it practically takes up the fill and stroke color properties of the bottom leveled element into our Inkscape canvas or document. Now one might be curious about, in some previous tutorials, I had discussed about grouping and ungrouping of the elements. Let's have a short discussion on it. So here comes the bottom level rectangle, and there goes the top level circle here. Now we are changing the fill and stroke color properties of this circle. We can see that this circle is having a different stroke and fill color here, different to the bottom level rectangular element. Now if we select both, and if we press Ctrl G, we can see that two separate objects, practically they are now turning into a single one. But as we can see that both these separate objects, those were grouped together as a single object right over here, those are practically behaving as a single unit, but both of them are retaining their own properties. Like this bottom leveled rectangle, it is having a separate red stroke and fill color, and the top leveled circle element, it is having a different orange and a deeper orange or brown color as a stroke and fill color. So we can see that practically both the objects, those are retaining their original color fill properties into their physical appearance. But if we now look into this union operation being conducted right over here on these two different objects, in this rectangle at the bottom and in this circle on the top, we can see that the top level circle element, it is taking up the physical properties, like this color and stroke properties, of the bottom level rectangular element. So both of them are practically behaving as if a single unit here, and the top leveled element or object, it is retaining the stroke and fill color properties and other physical properties of this bottom leveled rectangular object. So this is the principle of union operation conducted on two different objects.